us, which then opens up the avenue so that our savages can take care of the tarantulas. And the sledges, well, their job is to die, right? So as long as they die and they absorb a lot of shots, that's fine. Hello, everybody. Welcome. We played some additional Mechabellum over the last while. And I caught, let me just grab this. I caught some two replays that I thought were actually really, really, really interesting. Okay. So the first one was against Pew. I haven't seen something like this before. So I thought, you know what? I'll save it. And then we can have a look at it. All right. So, okay. Pew, our honored opponent, we start with the Farseer Specialist with the Tarantulas and the Fangs. And our honored opponent starts with the Cost Control Specialist, okay? And then that in conjunction with having some crawlers and having some stangs, right? So, for me, I've realized that I do better when I put people in positions that they are not comfortable in. So, I'm going to try and do a little bit of a push here on the one side, and then we'll see how it goes from there, right? Okay. They will not... Well, okay, so our opponent, Mr. Pew, is positioning at the back in this particular formation, right? So everything just right down the middle at the back. They are movement 16 units, so they'll probably do well. We opt to go for two arc lights, right? Arc lights are good against crawlers, they're decent against Mustangs. So we are having our push on the one side and we are having our arc lights on the other. All right, so... What is interesting about this positioning is it doesn't leave him all that vulnerable to this flank, right? Majority of his units will come in on the flanking position. Now, the arc lights off on the left, they are definitely winning their fight. Now, these Mustangs, in high enough numbers, they will kill the tarantulas. They're not proficient at it. But if you have high enough numbers, they will end up killing them. But then they still have two orc lights to deal with. So it looks like the first round is going in our direction. Cool. All right. So, yes, that's a bit odd. Now, we have rhinos, wasps, steel balls, and scorpions. Steel balls fits perfectly into the strategy that he has. And for us, I wanted to go for a rhino. I thought a rhino could be interesting. You know, if you... get the rhino, you give it the whirlwind, you know, that might be interesting because it can cut through the crawlers fairly easily and it will absorb a lot of damage from the Mustangs. Now, wasps were an option, okay, from that reinforcement list. So, we are getting Mustangs just so that we are prepared in case, you know, he decided to go for the wasps. Then at least we do have something that shoots up. Currently, we have absolutely nothing. We're getting an additional Fang squad here. And the idea with this rhino, the positioning here, is if we put it here, I'm not sure who wins this foot race, probably them, right? But it's worth a shot. It is definitely worth a shot. Bringing him in, giving them a huge target to pick from. He ended up going for the steel balls, though, and getting additional steel balls. So, yeah, I mean, between the steel balls and the crawlers and the Mustangs, this could become very difficult very quickly, right? And I placed the Fangs off on this angle. I couldn't afford another Mustang to try and cater for if he went for the Wasps. So, but he didn't. So now the Steel Balls are going to make life a little bit hard here. They're going to cut through the Tarantulas very quickly. Mustangs cutting through the Fangs very quickly. Arclight could kill a few more Mustangs, providing our tower doesn't die. So, you know, that could be nice. But with the Steel Balls, you know, and the little lasers cutting into the tower, there's not much of a chance. And then from here on out, we're essentially just watching our opponent mop the floor with us a little bit more. Right. And then they're going to turn, but yeah, we're not really going to get far with that. Okay. Right, and then he cleans us up. So, very aggressive strategy. The deploying in the back, I've never seen anybody just put everything in the back. I think the only place where I've seen that is... in that 4v4 free-for-all situation where they put like wasps and phoenixes and stuff all the way at the back. in order to try and get through it. Now, we do end up selling the Rhino, which is a good one. We do get our free Farseer, right, as we are the Farseer specialist. Both of our arc lights here can technically be upgraded, so we are upgrading both of them to make them level 2, just to see if we can maybe do something on this side. And this entire situation continues, right, so it's just more steel balls coming in at for now. Yeah, so there's one level 2 squad. There's another one that could potentially be a level 2 squad. Now, off on this angle, obviously those steel balls are going to create massive issues for us. They're going to cut through the arc lights super quick. We opted to go for a scorpion here, right? Scorpions can completely and utterly own the steel balls. So we're hoping that's going to happen. And we've got an incendiary bomb, which we essentially place here, hoping to just, absorb all of these crawlers and mustangs, right? Giving us a bit of a round win while we are trying to work on a counter for, you know, what our opponent is doing. These steel balls are going to have the absolute most fun they've ever had on this side. not much these arc lights are going to be able to do to stop them. But they are actually, because they are level 2, right, they are putting up a good fight. And some of them got distracted off on this angle, though. We are now able to clean up, right, between the combined firepower of the Scorpion and at least one level 2 Tarantula, right? So we are, at least we cleaned them up, but let's be honest, more than half of his entire army burned to death. So yes, that is interesting. Now we're going for a secondary Farseer, right? Because whatever upgrade you take on the Farseers, whichever one it is, they don't stack, all right? That's the first thing. And the second thing, going for another Scorpion, trying to absorb a lot of what's happening. You can see every round so far, it's essentially just been getting additional units, creating this long line of crawlers, and just stacking it with Mustangs and with steel balls. Now, I saw him take the missile, so I went for the underground threat, and I kind of dropped it on this side, just as a backup, like as a precaution. If we don't have enough units to fight on this side, maybe they can help with the steel balls, right? So the missile is coming in off on the left. It does kill most of the fangs. It really hurts this arc line. But off on the right side now, we have the two scorpions. These guys are still trying to push their way through, but the fangs are blocking them fairly well. So the fangs are going to take the damage initially, which is exactly what we want. The scorpions, if they do get shots on anything except these crawlers, that'll be really good. And over here, the underground threat will help us clean up the steel balls. However, on this side, you can see they're pressing in very hard, but they are targeting the Farseer, so that does leave us with a Scorpion that's left. And between the Farseer and the Scorpion, we do end up killing these steel balls, right? So we are kind of pushing it back, but it's really weird, right? Like, it's a really weird thing to do. So he immediately went for the Stormcallers, and then off on our side, we're trying to estimate what is a good choice here. We ended up deciding on the high-level Phoenix, right? I didn't know what was coming next. Like I said, I haven't really seen this. And this is a good play, right? So he immediately gets the Stormcallers, he gets the Incendiary Bomb, and that leads him to the purchase of his Sticky Oil Bomb, right? So drop the oil, they fire once, and you have all of those... all of that oil burning, and then we put the Phoenix off on this angle just to make sure we, you know, dealing with things. And this is the new ability from the crawlers, right? This is the loose formation. It means once they start running, they spread out very well. So they are less inclined to die to things like scorpions or any other AoE kind of thing, for example, the arc lights, right? So that drops. The Stormcallers do come in. We went for the Spider-Mine upgrade here. The Spider-Mines are maybe going to make it through the burning oil before they burn to death. Yes, some of them made it. And now Spider-Mines would have been really good, but you can see how well spread these crawlers actually become. And now we're launching more Spider-Mines into the middle of that chaos. These Phoenixes can clean up everything on this side, right? Maybe not before we lose the tower, but they can clean up everything. And now this combination that has come in kind of ended up killing us. All of our fangs burned down. We had zero chaff left off on this side. So unfortunately, we lose both of the towers at the same time. But again, going for these Phoenix, they've got a really cool skin. Look at that. Oh, yeah. But both of the Phoenix are left, and there's zero anti-air, right? So we are essentially just going to try and shoot everything as hard as we can until such a time as either the time runs out or everything dies. All right, so there we go. Boom, 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 boom. And four more Stormcallers. So the Phoenix coming in clutch here. And they've actually got enough experience to level. So not too bad. Right, cool. So again, next options here. We do get Fortified Mustangs, Acid Blast, Efficient Tech Research, and so on. I decided to go for the Fortified Mustangs because I'm now going to lean into them a little bit. He's got the double Stormcaller. So I need to get the Mustangs and I need to get that missile interception ability from them, right? Ironically enough, the Foreseer, the new unit, also has a missile interceptor built in. Okay. But I thought the Mustangs would be fine because we're in any way going to have to deal with all of these crawlers now, and they're becoming very difficult. So Mustangs are pretty good at that, right? So we're borrowing some money. We're getting additional reinforcements. We got 1, 2, 3 additional squads of Mustangs. And we are giving their range upgrade to all of our dudes, which will then help these guys, you know, depending on where they end up in life. Right, so the Mustangs immediately shoot down the missile that came out. That helps us a lot. It's going to shoot down all of the Stormcaller missiles, which means our little spider mines are actually going to connect this time around. Now, these Mustangs are a little bit fast, right? But as long as they absorb most of the shots there, we're fine. And you can see they completely and utterly try and surround us. We're engulfed, right? In a wave of fast units, in a wave of crawlers. This is actually quite hectic, right? The way it plays out. But we are still alive. We are still standing strong. We are fighting very hard down here. And the Scorpions trying to give them the business. The level 2 Tarantula actually doing a lot better than I thought it would. This Scorpion is going to die, but they are starting to run out of numbers, right? So we are trying our best. The Phoenix has survived up there, right? So, there's still a lot that can be done, but we do get the tower, and with that tower shot, we can see that steel balls have dropped. So this leaves them with only the Mustangs, and we are burning to death happily over here. Yay! But that leaves us with some Phoenixes left, with a Farseer and a Scorpion. And there we go. We got the tower. We got the Stormcallers, right? So, in a weird way, we are super outnumbered. It's like Protoss versus Zerg up in this bitch, but we are trying. So efficient research again. So I think he's gone for double efficient research. That's really strong. We are immediately borrowing money. We're making sure we are upgrading the Scorpions. We know that the missile came off of cooldown, so we are going to have to try and predict where that missile is going to go. But with the spider mines, you know, we need some kind of a stronger form of defense against the crawlers, because now they're becoming super difficult to kill. So we opt to go for 2 additional tarantulas, and just hoping that those initial mines are going to do well. Our incendiary bomb has come off of cooldown, which is really good for us here. It will allow us to at least burn a lot of them to death, and we do a mass upgrade of all of the fangs, right? Not leaning too heavily into new units, more just trying to make sure our old units do well. And we make sure we have the range on those Scorpions as well. Now for our opponent, Mr. Pew, he's got the range on the Steel Balls. This is a bit of an odd one, but sure, why not? And he's got Phoenixes, so he went for 6 additional Phoenixes with range. I'm guessing the Phoenixes are there to essentially try and deal with the Scorpions, right? And here we go. So we kick this off. We are dropping the incendiary bomb right there, just to try and deal with those things a little bit better. Still shooting down the missiles. Phoenixes are killing a lot of the spider mines, right? Not most of them. Most of them don't make it in on the first round, but we don't expect it to. It's like the second volley of spider mines that typically do damage, and they launch. They do very well. Off on this angle, the Mustangs are a big threat for the Phoenixes, but we'll see what happens. But over here, everything is just burned to death, and now we are just running up and killing everything. And the Farseers are actually surprisingly good at taking down Phoenix, right? So we've got the Farseers taking down the Phoenix, we've got the range boost everywhere with our army, and this seems to be it. The Spider Mines are coming in. Spider-Man. Anyway, I went Batman instead of Spider-Man. There we go. Okay, cool. So we managed to end up winning that round. But I've never seen anybody deploy like this before. So I thought maybe it would be interesting for you guys to see. And also, if you wanted to see what the new ability does for the crawlers, right, if you haven't been able to unlock it for yourself yet, that's what it does. It's actually quite sick. It's very strong. And it makes crawlers really, really, really good and efficient now. You can really swarm people now a lot better with the crawlers, which is very strong. And the second replay we're going to look at is against our honored opponent, Mr. Zorgos, right? Right, let's see what we got. So we've got Speed Specialist, Sabertooth, Cross Control, and Quick Supply. I love Quick Supply, but not with that unit selection. We decided to go for the Speed Specialist on this one. And our opponent, Mr. Zorgos, he has options between Rhino, Marksman, Giant, and Aerial Specialist. Let's skip this. We'll see what he picked once we get in there, right? So he decided to go for the Aerial Specialist. He starts with two Tarantulas and with three squads of Crawlers. We end up starting with two squads of Sledgehammers and with three additional Crawlers, right? Okay, so I also wanted to try out the Crawlers. I've just unlocked the Loose Formation. So I kind of thought, yeah, you know what, it's fine. Let's go into a couple of rounds. If you're by round three or four, it doesn't look like he's dealing with them efficiently. You know, we can start using the Loose Formation, but we'll just have to see how that plays out, right? Okay, so initial deployments, pretty boring, right? I'm just putting all my dudes so we can swarm in from angles and arrive hopefully at the right times, just as we engage in combat. And then our opponent dropped two Tarantulas there. He's gone for the same thing, the five additional Crawlers. And he's got four of them right behind the Tarantulas. I don't know if this is maybe too close to the Tarantulas, right? Because they're going to run past super quick. But because they're behind the Tarantula and behind the tower, it is going to make them split up into weird formations, right? So there we go. All right. Let's see what happens. Now, the Tarantulas, one Tarantula does better than one squad of Sledgehammers, right? They typically... a little bit stronger. I think if you put like a one-on-one fight between a squad Sledges and a Tarantula, the Tarantula typically wins. but some Crawlers were left, the Sledges were left. Now we get to see this in action. This Tarantula is going to eat these Sledgehammers alive. These ones tried, but yeah, we're not going to get anywhere, right? So there we go. Tarantulas are taking care of the business here. And that's it. Okay, cool. So, moving on from there, we now know that there's a lot of Crawlers. The options are Deployment, Elite, Berserk Rhino, and the Shield Airdrop. I opted for the Skip because I wanted to go for Wasps, as you could have seen in the background there. We'll check what he takes when he takes it. So, what I wanted to do is go for the Wasps initially, right? Crawlers can't do anything against it, and the Tarantulas, they do have the anti-aircraft upgrade, right? So, if he takes the upgrade, we're probably going to have to flip out the Wasps or something like that. But for now, getting them, I think, is a good idea. It should at least just give us a round. And then we'll see, you know, where we can go with them after that. So we've got four Tarantulas here. Very strong start, obviously. Still got the five squads of the Crawlers. Both of our little Wasp squads are... teleporting in there at the back, and as long as we can get a tower before we lose all of our chaff, we could probably win this round. So that went rather well. We get both of the towers, and now the Wasps are just pulling in, and they're going to start wailing on the Tarantulas in conjunction, you know, with the Sledges. But actually, the Sledges are still cleaning up Crawlers. Never mind. All right, there we go. So this round we're then getting, and we're getting it because of the Wasps. What's nice about doing a transition such as this one, especially if you do it early, is they typically kill enough things to go to level 2 immediately, right? It does make them pretty useful. So we got the Fire Badgers, Sandworms, Sabertooths, and Marksmen. I opt for the Sabertooths, right? It only makes sense to go for the Sabertooths. He's got all of these Tarantulas. It looks like he's leaning into them. So that should work. And then our opponent went for the Wraith, right? Or he just unlocked it. No, okay, so he went for the Fire Badgers, and then he's unlocked Wasps and Wraiths for himself. So we are giving the jump drive. We're moving these guys back. Usually they would respond, you know, with like Mustangs or something like that. And I was also worried because the Tarantulas do have this anti-air upgrade. So you could just drop a tarantula, give them anti-air, and essentially run us over, right? Like just steamroll us. But that's not what's happening, right? Two squads of wasps coming in. Essentially, these wasps, their job is to counter the wasps that we deployed in the first round. Now, we have moved them back. So they're not immediately going to get targeted by these guys. This would not be a good solution. Because these guys would probably start off as level 2, and these guys are level 1, and because they were already there for a round, they don't have to, teleport in anymore, so they'll just start the battle there. So, in theory, I could have left them there, and I would have killed these wasps fairly easily. Immediately going for that damage increase upgrade. Right, so Fire Badgers coming in, that's essentially just to control our little crawlers. Unfortunately, going for this upgrade has now lost all sense and meaning, right? It would make no difference for us to do that. The problem is our little wasps here, they're still good at killing the crawlers and stuff, right? So even if they do get taken out by these wasps, they'll still be good at killing the crawlers, but they are the only anti-air that we have, right? We have nothing else. Excuse me, that can potentially kill my opponent's wasps, right? So depending on how they maneuver and move like that, that's bad. So I was going to say, depending on how they decide to maneuver and move, we could still take these ones down. We are killing the tower, but they are going to kill the tower as well. And then these three are now isolated, and those two are isolated. So their little pack of wasps should actually be able to clean everything up quite nicely. Alright, we'll just speed that up a little bit. Now, we do kill that one, we do get in here. And yeah, okay, they ended up targeting the Sabertooth and the Sledgehammer, so we do end up taking them up, right? Now, where we are now, intensive training is good, barrier, I don't have giants, all of that, so yeah, we're going for intensive training. Both of our Sledgehammer squads can upgrade now, so we move them to level 2. These guys are going level 3, these guys are going level 3. We're going level 3 hopefully just to out-level these guys, but you can see here he spent everything he had on that squad to make them level 3. And then from here, we now need to start making decisions, right? He's going anti-air there, so these things are going to die very quickly. The moment they target them, they're going to die, that's just it. And we can see more wasps coming in. We decided to go for a Stang transition, okay? Mostly because I saw the two squads of wasps, and Stangs are pretty good against them, but Stangs will also help us clean up the crawlers, you know? And then going for one squad of crawlers, I didn't have a lot of money to spend in places, so the idea was to get one squad of crawlers and just see if we can make a bit of a distraction, right? Just to buy us a little bit of time, maybe bring around, and then afterwards we can always just sell them. Okay, so here we go, we are coming in. These guys are all distracted now by the crawlers, which is really good for us. It means that this squad of wasps will at least do their job before they die. Off on this end though, these wasps are immediately targeting our wasps, so they are just gonna fall over, right? And our only other anti-air is here at the back in this little group over there. But the Mustang should be able to at least do some kind of a damage to the wasps, just depending on how many of them survive this. So now it depends on who they target, right? If they target the Sledgies and all of that, Mustangs could potentially have taken them out, but with the tower going down, there's just no way. Right, so this is going to be a round for our opponent, Mr. Zorgos. He just went with the mass wasp, so we are going to have to find an answer. Now, all wasps are mostly useless, but they still absorb a lot of shots. So, you know what? I kind of felt like we could still keep them as chaff. It's fine. Barrier, orbital bombard, advanced offensive tactics, and that one. Both of us going for advanced offensive tactics, trying to get our damage up, right? Just do a bit more damage. Now, from here, we're getting an additional squad of Mustangs. We are getting the field recovery, right? So we can at least just sell these guys. And we are now a little bit between a rock and a hard place, right? We need to start deciding what is most important. We do have two squads of Mustangs. It's not enough to deal with this amount of wasps. But at the same time, we cannot afford to just constantly lose the frontline battles, right? So we're getting a third squad of Mustangs off on this side. It does leave the side a little bit more vulnerable, but you know what? You can't do everything all at the same time. And at least we now have level 2 Sledges and we have level 2 Sabertooths, right? So, okay. That's kind of what we're going to be doing. Now, of course, the Wasps over here, they are... he's going to keep them. He's going to level them as fast as he can. He gives them the loose formation, right? So it's harder for us to deal with them. And you can see how quickly they just open up and spread all over the show. But that's fine. So I dropped this to see if I can maybe lure the Wasps in. But I realized I was a little bit too forward, right? Just a little bit too forward. Right before the Wasps came and hit the crawler, so unfortunately we're not getting it. But we do have two squads of Mustangs here now, which is not terrible, right? Apologies. And if you think about it, there's actually a good composition that my opponent has, because the Fire Badgers are very good against the Mustangs, and his Wasps are good against everything else. So he is doing the damage, and he is in a bit of a commanding position right now. This obviously with the tower dying and with our last anti-air dying, yeah. We are in a little bit of trouble right now. But we kind of working on a composition that we are trying to use to do all of this. Now barrier, I can't use it. Improved Phoenix, pointless here. Mass produced raid, stupid. Vulcan's descent, what would be the point, right? So we are skipping this one. We are giving upgrades. We are giving the range upgrade to all of our Mustangs, right? And we are making sure that we are giving them levels, right? So those guys are level 2 now, and so on. We do still have the intensive training that might happen. Our opponent went for the mass-produced Wraith, right? So it decreases the recruitment cost of the Wraith by 100, but it also decreases the attack and the defense. Now, look at this. This is insane, right? So level 4, 2, 3, 4, and 2, and he's giving them the elite marksman, right? So they get plus 25% damage per level. So, you know, level 4, you're already getting a lot. It's a lot. So here again, we've gone for the last squad of Mustangs. We've given them the increased range, which should, in theory, deal with the Wasps now. And we are using our intensive training to just bring this Sabertooth up to level 2 as well. And to just buy ourselves a little bit of time, we're going for the enhanced range by the tower, right? Just to outrange them a little bit more. The enhanced range essentially ups your range of everything by 15. It's not bad. And so they already get the, you know, 40, so it at least makes it 55. So we should be outranging them. Now, these are mass-produced, right? Normally, Mustangs are not good against them. But they mass-produced, so they have 20% less health. So we should be able to cut through them fairly easily. And yeah, so we're now keeping our eyes on the Mustangs, right? Can the Mustangs kill the Wasps and the crawlers for us? Which then opens up the avenue so that our Sabertooths can take care of the Tarantulas. And the Sledges, well, their job is to die, right? So as long as they die and they absorb a lot of shots, that's fine. Now, this is looking a whole lot better. We can see here both of these Mustang squads are starting to cut through these Wasps, and we are cutting through the Wraith, right? So we now have officially enough anti-air and the right upgrades to deal with the Wasps. And the problem with the Wasps is that a lot of money went into them, right? We're nullifying a lot of money. Now, we opt to go for the Overlords because, honestly, at the end of the day, we seem to be fine on the ground, but we are running these things for a reason, so getting the Overlords can just help us by quite a bit. And of course, if you get the Overlords and you get the photon emissions, that again is going to help us a lot because it makes us tougher. We saw two of the Wraiths, so we decided to go for two of the marksmen, and we are going to give them the electromagnetic shot. So if he opts to go for that degeneration beam, it only takes one shot from a marksman to at least switch it off, right? So again, we are upgrading all of our Mustangs. We've got a level 3, 2, 2, and 2 now. We are now upgrading our crawlers just to make them a little bit tougher, okay? There's no point in just mass producing more crawlers. We're rather upgrading. Now, he went for 4 Scorpion tanks, right, to deal with the Sabertooths, and he's given them siege mode, so their range is incredibly long. They are also very good against Mustangs, right? They can one-shot so many Mustangs to death. But again, as long as these wasps are taken care of, I feel like we can kind of take care of the rest, right? So the overlords are helping, they're contributing on the ground fairly well, and their missiles will do nice damage against the wasps. But we've lost a lot, right? And a lot of these Mustangs are still going to die from the siege scorpions. But as long as these guys survive, we're in a good position. So we are now pushing back quite handily. And it does seem to be working out. So we've got Mothership, additional deployments, deployment module, and rapid cooling. I think additional deployments probably the best option here. So I'm going for that one. We are making sure that we are upgrading everybody. We are mass upgrading the Mustangs, and we're giving them the aerial specialization as well, right? There's wasps that we need to kill, and there's race that we need to kill. So giving them the stuff they need to do it very quickly is really good. We are using our intensive training to make this overlord level 2, this one leveled by itself. We are borrowing a little bit of money, and with the money that we've borrowed, we are going for the photon emission upgrade, right? So not really getting any new units. We are just pushing the levels of everything, right? If the last round was anything to go by, we should hopefully be okay. We can see additional wrecks coming in here. There's an additional scorpion as well. Okay, and this is what we have. This is our tanking line, literally our tanking line. Just the sap tubes and the sledges, and we've got two marksmen to hopefully shut down upgrades, and the rest is just we're in the rear with the gear, right? Just making sure that we can kill things. Other than that, not really a lot of upgrades being done on his side, unfortunately. I think getting the upgrades would have really helped. But yeah, so let's see how this one turns out. This could be the very last round for our opponent if he does not, you know, start winning the rounds back, or it could be the makings of an epic comeback. Now, he's giving the armor enhancement to the race, which I very much agree with, okay? Their biggest threat is the Mustangs, and Mustangs do struggle against them. So we've got the photon emissions coming out, and it covers a large chunk of our army. It does help us against those initial shots, but you can see these raids are still dying to the Mustangs, right? The Mustangs are very high level, and the race are still level 1, so they are still dying even with the armor announcement. Our overlords are packing quite a bit of a punch, but yeah, this is riding off of the back of the Mustangs, right? Essentially now a lot of level 2 scorpions here. That's pretty scary. But all the anti-air is dead. And he's on 700, so we pretty much know where this is going. He can't kill the overlords, and that's 400 supply, that's 400 supply, so that's going to be 800 damage. So he does end up cleaning up everything we have on the ground, with the exception of these two, if he misses. There we go. But unfortunately, it's just not going to be enough. And yeah, there we go. So I thought this was also a pretty interesting game, a little bit of a back and forth, if you will. Not as crazy as the first one we played, right? That was insane. But I thought this was a cool one. All right, guys, that's going to be it from me. If you haven't subscribed yet, I'm watching you. Please do so. Please leave a like, leave a comment, leave a whatever you want. Click the buttons, do the things, and then I'm going to see you guys for the next one. Okay, guys, bye.